Best Deputy Brendan Howland.
Gramagat Kian Corla. Taoiseach, the Women's Aid report published today highlights that in 2015, the National Domestic Abuse Service received 16,375 disclosures of domestic abuse against women and 5,966 disclosures of child abuse. That's a total of 22,341 abuse disclosures. Figures that will shock not only those of us in this chamber, but I think everybody across the country. Across Ireland, women have been choked, they've been scalded, strangled, punched, spat at, cut with knives, hit with golf clubs. These are acts, Taoiseach, of barbarism. Over the past 20 years, 211 women have been murdered in Ireland, almost half of them at the hands of people using their bare hands. In 2015 in Ireland, far too many women lived in fear. That continues this year. Fear of abuse, physical, psychological, fear for their children. That's something that we must, as a House, put an end to. So can I ask you, Taoiseach, we need clearly to do more to protect women in the home, protect women in relationships. So will you give a clear timeline to the House for the enactment of the Criminal Justice Victims of Crime Bill? Will you agree to amend that draft legislation to allow for young women in dating relationships who are not living with their partners to receive the same protection as envisaged for cohabiting couples under that draft legislation? And finally, Taoiseach, given the small amount of additional money required, will you agree now to extend funding for the 24/7 National Free Phone Helpline in recognition of the real issues that have been highlighted today in the Women's Aid report?
Thank you very much, Deputy Howland. Taoiseach.
What Deputy Brendan Howland has raised here is a litany of shame and of cowardice by those who inflict violence on women. Those who do so are not macho. Those who do so should be ashamed of themselves because they bring shame on our country. The request you've made, Deputy Howland, is one that I think we should have the opportunity to have the report debated here in the House. The Taoiseach was at the launch of the report this morning. I have every sympathy with the proposition that you make in respect of an amendment here of protection to be given to people who are the victims of this kind of crime. We've set out a range of priorities for legislation. Some are quite immediate in terms of issues that have already addressed. I'll advise Deputy Howland on the programme for the legislative for legislating for the Victims of Crime Bill. The final request you make in respect of coverage for the 24/7 helpline seems to be something that that should, of course, be available. I don't know the costs involved in that, but I'm sure a case can be made that would bring that about. If it protects one person fearing for their lives because of a call to be made, it's something that has to be considered. I just think the reading of this report today is part of the hidden Ireland, a dark Ireland that needs to be dealt with and exposed. And those who inflict that kind of brutality on women folk should be thoroughly ashamed of themselves.
Thank you, Taoiseach. Deputy Howland.
The Taoiseach for his reply. I think it is important that this report would be debated in this House, and perhaps the whips would set a time in the next week or two for that to happen. But I think we also need to follow through with practical proposals. And I look forward to hearing the timeline for enactment of the Criminal Justice Victims of Crime Bill, the heads of which were approved last year. And we should, if we can make a collective agreement now, to seek to have that progressed before the end of this session, the Taoiseach might indicate his willingness to agree to that proposal. And finally, in relation to the support for women's aid, I think the very least this House can do is to ensure that women who are in that vulnerable position have some mechanism to reach out on a 24-hour basis. So I would ask the Taoiseach to ensure that whatever resources are required to ensure that that service is available would be provided without delay.
Thank you. Well, I'll follow up immediately on that, Deputy Howland. In regard to the Victims of Crime Bill, obviously the new arrangement will allow for ministers to answer individually in respect of legislation under their responsibility, and that, I think, kicks in next week at Concordia. But in the meantime, I'll advise you on the progress made on the bill. In regard to the debate in the House, obviously the Whip has responsibility for 60% of the business and the Business Committee for the remainder, but I'm quite sure we can find an opportunity to debate and have debated, and it needs to be debated, a report of such profound implications for women all over the country.
Thank you, Taoiseach.